Hey kids, we are back on the racetrack. So here we are with another new race competition between Sridharana and Sidhana. So you gotta choose in which team you're gonna be. Is it Sridharana's team or Sidhana's team? You have to just WhatsApp Auntie Carla in the Hope Kids WhatsApp and tell which team you're gonna be. And so the one who wins is gonna have a prize and the one who loses will have a punishment. Wanna know what the punishment is? They'll be having a face full of maida, or what you call as flour. So you can just have fun and just don't forget to text Auntie Carla in which team you are. So kids, are you guys ready for this week's race? So here are our contestants, the one who lost the last game. The last week's game. So sad. Sridharana, he cheated actually. It's fine. We'll go to the next race for today. It's going to be the lemon and spoon. And kids, I want to just remind you guys, if you haven't texted Auntie Carla in which team you are, if you are in Sridharana's team or in Sidhana's team, just WhatsApp to Hope Kids group. Don't forget that. So the rules of the game are, once you keep the spoon in your mouth, do not touch it. Keep it straight, Sridharana.
No, straight.
Okay. Once your spoon and lemon, where's your lemon? Lemon are ready, put your hands back and you have to go to the end of the hall and come back twice. You guys ready? One, ready, set, go.
I like to move it, you like to move it, move it. Original King Julian for the case, man. I love how all the girls move their body.
So guys, here we are back in the garage for the punishment time. So here, Sidhu was very good at the lemon and spoon race, but it was a little bit of timing. That's fine. So here we are. We're going to put the floor on Sidhu's face.
One, two, three, go! Victory!
Hey kids, welcome back to the race. This changes everything. We're on week three. Can you believe it? Only one more week and our race is done. So the first week, do you remember what we learned? We saw Saul, the Christian killer, turned Jesus follower. Week two, we watched Saul, who's now become Paul, go on a missionary trip with Barnabas, where he preached the gospel to the Gentiles instead of just the Jews. Now we're on to week three. So today we're going to be looking at something totally different. We're going to look at the change that happens on the inside of us when we commit our lives to Jesus. I want you to take a look at my super cool toy car. Yeah, this is what Pastor Tim and I do every night when we're home. We race cars. Nice big wheels, cool orange color. Do you know what? How this car looks isn't how what makes it fast. It's what's on the inside. I want you to think of a real car, okay? If there's no engine or if there's no gas, that car could be the most amazing car on the outside. That's not anyway. Because what's on the inside is what matters. Life is kind of like a race. We have a finish when we're born. We have an end when we die. And there's a lot that happens in between. Sometimes we're ahead of the race. Sometimes we crash and burn. But what we're learning, and this changes everything, is that it's important you know the answer to all the in-betweens. Our go answer for today is Jesus changes us from the inside out. So kids, let's get ready to race! Paul's missionary journeys led him on some really crazy adventures. But you know what was really cool about Paul? Is on that day in Damascus on the road, he was never the same. Paul never one time looked back. He learned what it was to fully live for God, live by faith, and to always keep moving forward. His missionary journeys continued. Everywhere Paul went, he's kind of like our Pastor Tim. Everywhere Pastor Tim goes, he is always encouraging people in Jesus, helping them and pointing them to Jesus. Everywhere, in the market, when he's at the shop, anywhere Pastor Tim goes, he's talking about Jesus. Paul was the same. And in fact, what Paul did was he went to all the different churches and said, come on guys, keep going. Keep learning about Jesus. Keep becoming like him. And today, in the story we're going to see next, we're seeing Paul's second missionary journey.
Slapstick Theater. Paul and Silas. This is Paul.
Oh, hey.
Who told people about Jesus in lots of different places. One day, Paul was walking with his friend Silas.
Hey-o!
They were being followed by a girl who was controlled by an evil spirit. Her owners used her to make money. After days and days of this happening, Paul got so annoyed that he turned around and told the evil spirit to leave her. So the girl was freed.
Woohoo!
But her owners got mad at Paul and Silas because they wouldn't make any money off of her anymore. And they had them thrown in jail. The jailer locked them up.
Oh, man.
Around midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing to God, and the other prisoners were listening. Suddenly, there was an earthquake, and the chains of all the prisoners fell off.
Oh, what just happened?
But Paul and Silas didn't leave, even though they could have. Several people decided to follow Jesus that night, including the jailer and his whole family. And the next morning, they were released from jail, and the city officials even apologized to them.
Sorry about that.
Paul and Silas encouraged the Christians in the town, and they continued on their mission to tell people about Jesus.
See ya!
We saw in that video that Paul and Silas had a really, really bad week. There was a crazy lady, there were people wanting to kill them, and now they're caught in a prison. What would you do if you were in that situation? I think a lot of us would probably quit, but not Paul and Silas, because Paul had been changed from the inside out. And when Jesus changes us from the inside out, he puts a peace and a joy that can't be shaken by anything. We saw what had happened on the inside of Paul in that prison cell. Because when all of these bad things happened, the earthquake came, they were worshiping Jesus. It wasn't, my mom did this, my dad did that. Wasn't a bunch of complaints or crying. They worshiped Jesus. That's how we know that Paul was changed from the inside out. For Paul and Silas, it was the hope that they had on the inside of Jesus taking care of them, of going to heaven one day, that helped them to worship instead of worry. It was because of Jesus that the jailer and his whole family, their hearts turned from the inside out, from worshiping other gods to worshiping the one God. It was because of Jesus that the demon-possessed girl went from having something from Satan inside her to having God inside her. Are you seeing a pattern here, kids? Jesus changes us from the inside out. And Jesus changes everything. Hey kids, we're in the garage because we have some work to do. You know how before Paul gave his heart to Jesus, he was Saul and he had a lot of changing from the inside out? Well, even after we know Jesus, there are still changes on the inside that need to come out. So let's just take a look. I have one bowl full of really dirty water. You see that? Definitely gross. And here, this is crystal clear, and you can even, it's so clean, you can see the cloth sitting inside. So now, I wonder, if I take this cloth out of this bowl and I squeeze it, what kind of water am I gonna get? Let's check it out. I'm sure you guys know this. Ugh. That is definitely not clean water coming out of that cloth. I didn't really expect anything else to come out of it. I was hoping for chocolate milk or maybe some Pepsi, but I dipped it in dirty water, so all I got was dirty water. Let's take a look at this cloth in the clean bowl. What are we gonna get? You bet, we're gonna get clean water. Why? Because we dipped it in clean water. You know what, kids? We can have all the best clothes. We can have really, really good marks. And we can look like the coolest, smartest kid in our whole class. But if what's inside us is dirty is gonna come out. If we're disrespectful of our parents, or we're jealous of what our friends have, or we even think bad thoughts about other people, that makes the inside become dirty. Just think of a car. It's got a beautiful paint job like the ones you see here. They are so cool. But if their engines are all rotted out and we can't drive them, they're no good. You know what? That's the same as us kids. Let's take a look at a scripture verse. Proverbs 4:23 says that our hearts determine the course of our life. What does that mean? That means that what's in our hearts, what's in our thoughts that nobody sees, those things are driving our car. And if we're thinking, feeling a lot of bad things, kids, our car isn't gonna go where we want it to go. And this reminds me of how Jesus changes us from the inside out. What do you have on the inside that Jesus needs to take out? Because remember, what's in your heart is driving your car, and you only get one chance at your race called life. Let Jesus change you from the inside out. We need to look at God's word and learn our go verse for today. It is found in the New Testament, in the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 5, verse 17. Wow.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah, that's a super exciting outfit you got there.
I know. Thank you.
So, what is this all about?
This is, you told me to change, so I changed.
What? I told you to change.
Yeah, you remember yesterday you came to my room and you scolded me, so.
Sid.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, I told you to change your attitude. I didn't tell you to change your clothes. Remember, I came in, I told you to clean your room like a million times, and you were like, I'll do it later. You're always telling me to clean my room. And I said, you need to change your attitude. Yeah, that's kind of not the same thing as changing your clothes.
Okay.
Yeah, your attitude is on the inside. This is on the outside. Hey, you know what? Actually, I was just teaching the kids 2 Corinthians 5:17. Do you know what it says? This is perfect for you.
Okay. You can listen.
Yeah, would you do that for once? Are you ready? Okay, 2 Corinthians says, the old life is gone and a new life has begun. How do you think that happens?
I have to change my attitude, like, you know, my old ways, and be a new person.
But how does it happen? Who makes it happen? I mean, I do because he's afraid of me.
God?
Yeah, Jesus. Jesus changes everything. So this verse is good for you. The old life is gone and the new life has begun.
All right, then.
So what I want you to do is probably head home in your bedroom.
Yeah.
All right. So kids, 2 Corinthians 5:17, what does it say? The old life is gone and the new life has begun. Of our race today, we've seen how Jesus changes us from the inside out. Not just with salvation, but every day Jesus can change things that aren't quite right on the inside. And we'll see them on the inside. And maybe you have some things you'd like Jesus to change today. Let's pray. Jesus, you are a miracle worker. I pray that you would take everything that's in me that doesn't show your love or how you've rescued me, would you change it and turn it into something beautiful? Just like you took those things out of Saul and he became Paul. You saved the jailer, the demon-possessed girl. I want to be changed from the inside out. In Jesus' name, amen. We're going to finish today by doing what Paul and Silas did in the prison. We're going to worship Jesus. Join with me as we worship Jesus because he changes everything. Jesus, your love. Darkness around me. But you surround me with your love. Jesus, your love. You are my rescue. You are my savior. You'll always keep me.
Jesus.